There is an element of this from the conference in the system as well.
Legal possible council tax.
Yes, we
our commitments as if they were quite straightforward in what we said as we went into the election. Quite straightforward.
I can't do it.
Just picking up on that, on page 25 of the diagram, table at the bottom, it lays out very starkly the drop in the general fund balances from 2014-15 onwards. And we know what your budgets were in between, but how much consideration did you give for managing some of that through council tax? Because obviously you've got your general fund balances dropping, you know that the core service is rising. Where was your balance of judgment in that time? And bearing in mind the issues about what was or wasn't promised for the local elections.
Clearly, that balance has to be taken into account by anyone who's proposing a level of council tax. It's something that one considers. But when one has increased the burden of taxation on some of the people who can at least afford to pay, I think it's something that one needs to keep a very close eye on. I don't like council tax as a tax, and I think we should try and keep it as low as we possibly can.
But is it rational to raise the bank and that does seem to be a difficult intellectual line of
thinking.
Yeah. to employ, I think we're going to have to do that.
Negotiation.
Then, is it looking to be, when you tomorrow night, asking question, I would like to add a recommendation. And from our point of view, this recommendation will decide how we vote. If the recommendation is accepted, we're quite happy to know and approve it. If it's not, we won't get a vote for this report. And that recommendation is that, as a matter of urgency, all functions to do with strategic finance are brought back in-house. It was part of the original contract, so there shouldn't be a penalty for it. And I think we even need to control, at a strategic level, the finances, basically, and the prediction.
That's seconded, okay. So that has to go to the vote. So I think that what we should do is that this should come back to the July meeting for consideration. Will you accept that?
If the July meeting includes the options that we can vote on to bring the strategic finance section, if you like, or functions back in house, it needs to be.
I think we need, before we do something like that, we need a proper paper. So
we have to check with options. Because I'm a bit wary of changing it then rather too often. But if
we undertake to bring one back in July.
Bring a paper back with the option that we can vote on. Is that one of the options?
Yes, that's an option.
Okay, we're waiting to write it.
Okay. So can we agree, Councillor Gordon's additional recommendation, please? All those in favour, thank you very much. So it's unanimous. So moving to the recommendation.
I interjected on the breakfast quickly with one.
Yeah, carry on.
It was actually generally, I think, Councillor Cohen's response didn't actually answer Councillor Houston's question about the brown bins. It wasn't about extending them to areas like where I live for 15 years and never been able to do any recycling. So Councillor Rosa Burke, I'll be writing to you as my ward councillor. And I think that was slightly disingenuous. The thing that happened at the Environment Committee last week was there an item around recycling. It was a financial report with resource implications. Changes were made by the chair of that committee and I believe the vice chair of that committee. One was around the brown bins. If people still want to recycle their food waste, carry them the way you do it.
Mike.
And the other one was
Mike, please.
Yeah. Oh, sorry. Yeah.
Unless you're not safe to be
here anyway. Basically, two changes are made with resource implications. One was the vice chair said, can we look at people still want to recycle their food in brown bins? Can we revisit it and see can they still do it? And the other one was a green waste, which was the initial response was to the recommendation was suspend collection for 3 months and a recommendation change to say to do it to 6 weeks. Are we now saying that councillors across the board of committees can make massive changes to the recommendation by officers even when there is a financial implication? In the past we were told we couldn't. I think last week the precedent has now been set. Any councillor, backbench or opposition councillor can make recommendations where there is a financial implication. My preferred option last week, the report should have been withdrawn and come back with proper costing if you were running council, but it seems the precedent has now been set.
Thank you for that observation. Can we go to the recommendations, please? Can I take them all on as notice? With the additional recommendation there, thank you very much. Moving on to the local development scheme, page 54.